In the last video, I built DIY BMS, and guess what? Today, I'm going to program it.
First, just a quick recap of the previous episode. I started from ordering DIY BMS boards from JLCPCB. I uploaded the Gerbers to their website and started from navigating their list of components and finding substitutes for the missing parts. Unfortunately, some of the components I could not be found, so they will have to be soldered in later on. I had to order the controller as well as the modules. After a reasonably short wait, the boards have arrived. To my delight, the quality was very good and very few components were missing. The one key component that I really needed was 80 tiny microchip, which goes in each module. And of course, as the luck would have it, I found a whole bunch of them in my drawers. So I started from building the modules and then quickly progressed to the controller. And here we are, now at the stage where the modules and the controller need to be programmed. Stuart now developed a much easier way to program the ESP32 and the modules. Basically, we can now use NodeMCU Flasher to program ESP32. So I've downloaded the binary pre-built for this purpose and initiated programming, having chosen the automatic selection of the port and reasonably fast speed of programming. The programming went successfully without any problem, and next I will need to set up the Wi-Fi access point. To do this, first I wanted to check the COM port, which we used to connect, and fired up a PuTTY terminal. So in this case, we need to select the COM port that we just checked and specify reasonable speed. And after that, we can start the terminal. When terminal started, using command line, we can configure Wi-Fi access point. This step is very easy to do. You just need to select your Wi-Fi point and enter the password. And after this, DIY BMS will give you IP address you can use for connection to the controller. Okay, now we've programmed the controller. We will try to program the module. And to program the module, I will require a ribbon cable, and I need to connect pin 1 on the controller to the pin 1 on the module. But before I connect the module, I need to enable programming mode. So our DIY BMS is still connected. So to go to programming, we go to AVR programming. And now I need to click enable programming mode. Some features are disabled and AVR programming is enabled. So now we connect our module. In this case, pin 1 is over here. Hopefully that's correct. Yeah. And that's our pin 1. And now we need to select the module 4.40, but I'm not sure which one is that. We got this one, comms 5K, comms 9K6. I think it depends on the resistor. I think I just 4.4. This would be my module there. And I was just gonna say, program the device. It's programmed. So that means we can do another one. Hang on a second, pin 1. Pin 1 is here. So yeah, that's gonna be this way. And hopefully now you can see the module itself. And now I can do program the device again. So you can now see the LED is on. And it's programming the module. Success! That's fine. So now we have two modules programmed. After that, I programmed a few more modules, including an older version which I had from the previous build.
Now I've programmed modules and the controller, I can start actually testing it and finishing it with these four modules and actually run it with the real battery. Also, I'm planning to solder in all those relays and some of the connectors that I received recently. Now I'm connecting those communication wires, and in this case they have to be crossed effectively. So now we can connect the modules. So the modules have to be connected in series. So the controller has transmit-receive connections on it. So we will start from a transmit connection, and transmit connection should go into receive on the module, which happens to be on this side here. So that's a connection between transmit and receive. And then next one would be between transmit of this module, which will go into the receive of another module, which is this side here.
I connected other modules in a quick succession.
I have now connected all the modules, and it sort of turned out to be some sort of a star type of configuration. The transmit goes into the receive of the next module, and then transmit of this module goes to the next receive of the other module, etc., 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 and then they go in turns. So at the same time, I will be now connecting the modules to the battery. I will connect the power supply. I have soldered in the 5 volts because I still don't have a connector here. So if I now power on the board, we shall see that ESP32 should boot in, and you see the green LED is on. This means that we can start connecting. And now I will start connecting the first module. Okay, so the first module is connected. And then the next would be this one, this cell over here. And now we can connect this module as well. So we are getting first module discovered, and we have an error that controller found 4 modules but we configured for only 1 module. Okay, so that's where we have 4 modules but we have a number of parallel banks. So in this case we have only 1 bank, and hopefully now we should get our 4 modules, and here we are. So we have modules 0, 1, 2, 3, which is 4 modules, and we can see their voltages.
Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you wanted to see how I build DIY BMS, look at this video over there. The next step would be to configure it, set up the modules, and progress further. So I will see you in the next video.